Yeah, this wouldn't be the first time I've said this, but I enjoyed making this film more than I've enjoyed making any other. And I think in part it's because the frequency of, or the tonality of the film, that because it is a family film, it gave off a sort of warm radiation to everyone that was involved in it. And I found that the cast and the crew also felt that. So it had a kind of good vibe from its inception to the end. Although it was terribly challenging, it was challenging in all the right ways, in no small part because it's a musical and because it was a family film. And now I'm not particularly familiar with those, with that experience. But it was, I suppose, the warmth. Ultimately, it was the warmth of the project, where I'm familiar with making slightly darker, more macabre stories. It was refreshing to make something that gave off a sort of warm radiation. We first meet Aladdin, where there are two grifters trying to work their magic on him, and it quickly becomes realized that he's one step ahead of them. And there's a thief working on a thief, with charm. So what we were after was a street thief with charm. And then one thing leads to another, and swiftly we realize he's a thief with a heart. Not only with charm, he's with heart when he comes to the defense of who transpires to be Princess Jasmine. But at the time, there is no revelation that she's anything other than a young lady who he feels he should protect. You know, the most challenging component of this film was, I think, the casting. It went on for at least a year, and we looked on all the continents that this planet has to offer. Naomi was in with very tough competition, you know. All these girls had magnificent voices. They all looked spectacular. They had tremendous charisma. They were wonderful actresses. So they had all of the prerequisite ingredients that an audience and a director could desire. But there was something about Naomi and her enthusiasm, her boundless generosity of spirit, which was gradually became so conspicuous. It became clear that she was going to be who we wanted our Jasmine to be. Yeah, I mean, before you get there, I'll tell you what was a tricky one. And we really threw a lot of man hours at that, and that was Friend Like Me. Did that suck up some creative man hours. And that really was a team effort. Prince Ali sort of revealed itself quite organically. It was going to be what it was going to be. It was, here is Prince Ali revealing himself. As he presents himself to the royal family and the sultan and the princess, as it were. So you're confined, you're bound and limited by a scene, if you will. Well, that's not the case with A Friend Like Me. A Friend Like Me is you pull the pin out of an intergalactic creative universe, but somehow you have to make a cohesive narrative or out of that limitless clown's pocket. Inherent within the DNA of Aladdin is a cinema experience rather than to a home cinema experience. So it's just too big. It's too big a premise and too exotic a premise. So I as a director am allowed to enjoy all the benefits of deep and creative pockets. But in order to fully appreciate that, it's a big screen experience. In a time where there's a polarization between big screen and small screen experiences, you know, as I say, it's inherent within the DNA of Aladdin that it's a big screen experience.